The state of Alaska contains 86 active volcanoes. These volcanoes are all collectively rated by the U.S. Geological Survey as ranging between very low threat and very high threat designations. These designations generally seem self-explanatory, as for example, Mount Redoubt is rated as a very high threat volcano based on its proximity to Anchorage. Yet, of the volcanoes in the highest threat category, one stands out, the Makushin volcano. Its location on the chart at first seems misplaced, as the Okmok volcano, which ejected 50 cubic kilometers in one of the planet's largest recent explosive eruptions, leading in part to the downfall of the Roman Republic, is only listed as a high-threat volcano. In contrast, its placement on this list makes perfect sense when you realize that no one lives within direct reach of Okmok, but 4,724 residents live on top of young deposits from Makushin at the town of Unalaska. If this town were to have been present either 8,000 or 8,800 years ago, it would have been completely annihilated by long-reaching pyroclastic flows, which traveled 15 miles or 25 kilometers distant from the volcano. Although the recent eruptions from Makushin have been relatively small, there is a threat that such a major eruption could repeat in the future, hence its very high threat designation. The Makushin volcano is located in the central Aleutian Island chain, where it is emplaced on the northern section of Unalaska Island. It is an unusually broad volcano, measuring 10 miles or 16 kilometers across. This volcano began forming 930,000 years ago when a volume of basaltic andesite composition magma erupted onto the surface. As it erupted, it produced a series of powerful explosions, and due in part to numerous pyroclastic flows, the existing island was expanded by several miles to the northwest via a plateau of newly erupted ash. Over the next several hundred thousand years, the erupted lava became more silica-rich as it transitioned from basaltic andesite to andesite. Over time, a large gray-colored stratovolcano was constructed, which produced numerous volcanic explosive eruptions. As the central volcanic peak was built to a height of more than 5,000 feet, glaciers expanded across its edifice. During interglacial periods when these receded, volcanic activity became possible at satellite vents. These secondary vents produced large lava dome-forming eruptions, but also viscous andesite lava flows. One such lava flow is known as Lava Ramp, which covered 50 square kilometers of land in viscous lava. One satellite vent soon became the center of activity, erupting near continuously for several thousand years, building the 3,000-foot-tall Makushin cone with a 760-meter-wide summit crater formed from powerful explosive eruptions. To the northwest, intrusions of magma interacted with the area's abundant groundwater, causing it to flash to steam and explode. These explosions carved out large craters along a northwest-facing trend, some of which are more than 2,000 feet wide. After the most recent glacial period ended, a group of powerful explosive eruptions occurred. One such eruption in 6790 BC began with the creation of a large bulge on the northern slope of the volcano. This bulge eventually burst, resulting in a Plinian eruption which created a 37-kilometer or 121,000-foot-high eruption column. As the north flank of Makushin partially collapsed, it traveled northwards at incredible speeds, the landslide only stopping 5 miles into the ocean. Highly energetic pyroclastic flows associated with this eruption reached the modern town of Unalaska, depositing a foot thick of superheated rock over what is now the town's main port. Then, due to the large amount of erupted material, which totaled 7.5 cubic kilometers, a 2.5 kilometer wide section of the volcano collapsed downwards, forming a massive caldera. A similar magnitude eruption occurred in 6050 BC, deepening the overall caldera and depositing 10 feet of superheated tuff on the western edge of Broad Bay. The vast majority of eruptions which have occurred since, with the exception of another large eruption in 3650 BC, have been comparatively small, occurring as a series of small volcanic explosions at Makushin's summit crater. During the 20th century, Makushin erupted 10 times, producing a series of phreatomagmatic and phreatic explosions, which widened its summit crater. Although the next eruption from this volcano is also likely to be small, there is always a possibility that another unusually energetic pyroclastic flow could occur from an additional caldera-forming eruption. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Phil Webster, for supporting this channel.